Come on.
Let's just see it turn tight and then you can
hurry
start
up.
Coming down the ramp with the singing voices, ladies and gentlemen, on 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Tim Lewis. Happy birthday to you. Hip hooray! Hip hooray! Hip hooray!
Louis Hall. Louis Hall. Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! Smash the cake!
Because we want to enjoy the cake. So we're going to pass it right over to you. Now girls, stand close by because if he touches the bottom, he has to kiss the nearest girl.
Good night!
Now make sure you
smash the cake! Flashlight on my phone. I don't have a flashlight on my phone. Yes, no. This is a.
Hey, you see the Wiggles?
Yeah. Yes. The Wiggles. The Frank Sinatra Center.
See the Wiggles?
Oh, see the Wiggles.
Yep.
Do you like the hot potato?
Yeah, let's see your hot potato!
What do you prefer? Coles
spaghetti.
Mashed banana.
Alright. Alright. Mashed banana.
Sorry, that's mashed
banana.
Alright, now we're going to throw over to the family.
The best.
Some speeches. So come on around, ladies and gentlemen. And listen up while a few words are spoken.
Let's be words.
Who's up first?
All right, give it up for Bat Dad, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, Batman!
Batman!
And he's just getting the speech ready, putting in large text.
I'm filming.
Hi everybody. Of course, thank you everyone for coming and putting me in such a great effort. I thought I'd be embarrassed up here, but looking out there, so what are we doing? We're talking about Nick, who turned 18. Isn't that fantastic? Yeah, he gives us one of them. I'll take our minds back a little bit before we were born. You know how we all go through the hood and all and trying to work out, what are we going to call our kids? Brett, Bill, Jack, Mary, that's the girl. Anyway, Lisa was sitting on the couch one day, probably about 8 months pregnant, and she's trying to wobble her ass off the couch. And her skirt goes up. She had no underwear on. And I said, oh, you're Nicholas. And that's how we got his name.
Nicholas! Yes, Nicholas! He's a horse.
Okay, so the first 3 years of Rick's life, we didn't realise he was autistic. We had no idea. We just thought he was as slow as the rest of us. But it turns out he had autism. And with life changing for all of us, Lisa and I did a lot of soul searching, internet searching, which I'm sure all of you other mothers out there and fathers out there did the same thing, looking for a cure, looking for an answer, looking for why it happened.
There's no why.
And in the end, we kind of realised there is no cure for it. nothing much you can do about it except accept it.
And you accept it. Is,
and I'm only doing for what they are.
Bring it on.
And so at least when I set it, his expectation at about zero. We sort of didn't expect anything from him. We thought maybe we would just we'd push him around in a chair or something or whatever. But along the way, he achieved certain milestones. And one of the most magnificent milestones was nappy, getting rid of a nappy. And he was able to wipe his own ass.
Oh my God!
And then just recently, Nicholas has started eating everything that Lisa served up. So he's eating vegetables and this and that, and that's a big deal. That she's not enough to cook two different meals for Nick and us. And he seems to be enjoying what she makes. So we really love that. And another milestone, one of our big highlights has been
what?
One of our three children, Nick is the only one to go to year 12.
He's year 12!
Celebrate his big day. But I'd like to firstly thank Linda Gardner. Helping Lisa set all this up today. The pair of them worked beautifully. And together, so
that's okay.
Yep. I also have to thank our kids in France for the great job. There's a lot of work they've done with Vic over the years, and how quickly and readily they accepted him. And they've loved him and taught him stuff that, I just couldn't imagine was going to happen. They were there from farm to sit on the toilet or in front of the toilet trying to encourage him to do stuff. Rhiannon's always loved him and done stuff and mucked about with him. And it's not just our kids, it's also our nieces and nephews that have just, like Joanna and Julia and Lucy, they've all embraced him and loved him too. And for me, looking at that has been amazing. I've loved every minute of it, just quietly. And then, of course, we haven't met Daniel, and he came along, and immediately Daniel just, there you go, Nick.
Yeah. How are you doing, and Nick?
And I think that's wonderful. And
Nicholas is a wonderful uncle.
And that's right, he's a great uncle.
Great uncle.
I'd also like to thank Phil and Louise, because early in the piece there, it's always a struggle to find someone to babysit, and Phil and Louise always put their hand up and said, yeah, we'll take him, we'll bathe him, we'll feed him, we'll do whatever we have to do. So guys, I love you both. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Another couple, Emma and Kevin. Oh, there you are. Yeah. Emma and Kevin down the front.
Kevin.
They have done amazing things with Nick too. They take him to the pictures whenever they can, and they've done a hell of a lot just to embrace him and what he is. So, if you're worried about people staring at an autistic kid, wait for a couple of short steps of people taking to the pictures as well.
Taking the pictures as well.
And they handle it so beautifully. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing. Thanks, guys. I really love it.
Yes!
Woo! I'd also like to point out Nick's uncle, Paul.
Hang on.
Uncle Paul has been, as in their thought, he has been absolutely sensational with Nick. He just roughed him up, he hugged him, he picked him up, he wanted him, and does all these amazing things. And I sit back and go, thank fuck for Paul. It's a great thing to do, I love
it. You have belly. Yay! You're well, then.
They have the families, of course. And I can't say too much, I'm kind of joking up over
it's a joke.
But anyhow, I've just spent the last 18 years watching Lisa tirelessly work with Shane before you board, mate. Have you ever?
That's the hint.
Lisa has been just an absolute rock. She has not missed a beat. She accepted him straight away for what he is and loves him and made him her very special boy. And for that, again, I couldn't love Lisa any more for the hard work and the effort she put in. So, Nick, what can I say? Good luck for the future. You're only 18, you've got a long, long way to go. And all I just want to say is that your mum and I will be here for you until we go. We'll always be here for you. Good luck.
Good luck in the future.
Thank you, everyone. Coming. Have fun. For Hulk. My name is Bruce Banner.
That's you.
That's my girlfriend, Betty Ross. I'm going to Freyston Hospital.
What?
I'm being Dr. Bruce Banner. I'm turning a Hulk.
What?
Nicholas!
Lisa, she'd like to thank you all for coming. She'd love to speak with her on the phone, but she thinks she's going to figure out the problem. Let's give her a big round of applause and put her on such a
big round. Ladies and gentlemen,
give yourselves an awesome big round of applause too. There are so many fantastic costumes. I thank all of you for coming dressed up tonight personally as well. Give yourselves a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Take up shortly. We're going to get back into some party time. Request a welcome as well. So if there's something you want to hear, please come up and see me. I believe we've got some ABBA coming up the capital.
Just covering the lens.